The Gunnel Grabbers of Michigan went on their 12th annual canoeing trip this year to Northern Ontario. To meet the challenge of the Goat River, one of the many rivers in the James Bay watershed.
South of Oba.
And
we're just trying to get our wings flapping to take off. Breakfast.
So, what are you doing?
It's time for breakfast. Here's to you.
Taking that Agawa Canyon thing?
I did.
Did you?
Mm-hmm.
Was it worth it?
I did in the fall. Massive search spot ski area.
Outside my window, I hear the lonesome whistle whine. Down the tracks, 50s rolling, wheels clicking out the time. Always leaves me lonely, never satisfies my mind.
At beautiful Oba, we had a four-hour layover, so we set up a breakfast cookout. Next to the station, we had pancakes and bacon, and then we were entertained by Scotty as we leisurely waited for the Canadian National.
Here we are at Oba State Park.
Oba State Park?
Yep. I don't think we have Provincial Park. There's our campfire.
Anytime you're around people, you're better off having them, I guess. You never know.
The queen's the plan, but it's not.
But liability.
Mm-hmm. This is really $6.
You can stay there.
Yeah.
With the exchange.
$6.80.
Well, you just have the satisfaction of
placing that upper space.
That's not a guy down there.
Good morning, Fox. Oh, that's cool. Now, who said there weren't any foxes in Oba?
We haven't even had a six-pack.
What's she doing?
Yeah.
Well, this is it. we can't stop this one, we're in trouble. Guess what? We didn't stop it. I guess it's not the right one.
You done yet?
What's going on?
It's cold. Stolen.
Well, we're hoping this is the one. All right, we made it. Got dropped off. This is Lake Minnipuka. We want to head off to the north here. You ready, Joe?
I'm ready to go.
All right.
Want to get warm and light?
Well, we're on Lake Minnipuka, and some of the guys went out fishing, and the weather's kind of cold and raw and windy. The weatherman's not in control yet.
The weatherman's not?
No, and we found this little shack with some heater, and Al's of the mind that we ought to sit here until the weather clears. The rest of us are kind of letting him take us that way. We decided that the room was nice and warm anyway.
That's a little shack that we found that was had a fire going. Group that was picked up at the lake. Must have started the fire. Still a little windy and rough out there. I'm going to wait it out a few minutes. See if the weather breaks before we head down the lake. We've got to head straight into the wind.
The Canadian National trip was only a very short run. In the water, down Lake Minnipuka to our first campsite. A beautiful spot with good tent sites, good fishing. The weather was overcast but cool and dry. We had a nice evening of fishing and relaxation. We checked our maps and then proceeded the next day through the Narrows and then into Goat Lake.
We just went around our first portage on the river stream between Minnetuka Lake, Minnetuka, and Goat Lake. Had to portage around a waterfall. You can't see the whole thing right here.
A good 10, 12 foot drop. Not much to do in a canoe. Paddle up into the, I'll get it filmed. Shelves, we've got a portage around. People ask us why we do it. Here's one of the reasons. You get to see this. We don't pay some national park fee. Tuesday morning. Do a little fish fry here. Some fish, walleye we caught yesterday. Maybe one or two pike.
Oh yeah, put a half right here.
It's cold and it's wet. Getting some hot in their stomach before we get started.
You get some out? Oh yeah, I have some.
After lining around the left side up there, we've come through. Nice stretch of rapids here, a little bit of a shelf.
Center!
Center!
Center! That's good! Woo! That's it! Good run, good run, good run!
Stay in the middle.
Stay in the middle, you can go right down the middle. Stay to the left of that big rock down there.
Left?
Left of that rock. Big rock, way down. Just pick your way through.
A nice shoot right after that one waterfall. Came through a nice rock canyon shoot.
Wow.
Everybody's too safe. Well, Mom, we understand the last instructions were take care of my boy. We're going to find out right here whether that's going to happen or not. Fire by baptism. Come on, Steve, pull him through it.
You got to get onto the braces part.
All right. Oh, yeah. Oh, look at that.
Good run.
Came in over the bow, didn't it?
Yeah.
Come right over. Ah, my rain truck. Tried him out a little bit. It was coming in.
Keep it on. Keep it on. Woo! And a boy. But you're grabbing. Whoa. We have it captured. A gunnel grabber.
The following day, we proceeded on down Goat Lake in heavily overcast weather. Our first rapids were encountered, which Bud and Tom took successfully, and all the others portaged.
Uh-oh. Look what happened to the canoe.
Sharp rock. Tom comes out of Foldy Canoe and he purchased this.
Burglars. We're just to document which canoe got ripped up.
Boy, I like those daggers.
They're a little smaller there.
All right, a little butchathane, a little duct tape. Red Green Show would be real proud of us.
Well, we are in Canada.
Right.
There it is, the red green two guys right there.
Here, red green.
Huh? Stick on the ice. Suspenders
on that. I got my red suspenders on my green pants, huh?
This is what happens when the water's low. You have to line your canoes through the low spots. It's just too low water to...
For balance. Got the tree for balance. Balance yourself in the canoe. Hold right onto it.
It was below this area that the low water began to give us trouble. All the canoes got hung up at one time or other, but the two Grumman canoes with their keels were the most difficult to get over the rock beds. There was a lot of short portages, dragging canoes around the log jams and through the shallows. Several times we kept the canoes loaded and used a four-man carry.
Hurry up!
Thirsty.
This is an interesting predicament we haven't run into before. Canoe goes under. Canoe rider goes over. Kind of tricky. We've come to a log in the middle of the road, and so we are tactfully getting off with the tree.
We're gonna go, Alan.
Yeah.
Say something, Al. Hello.
I'm glad I'm done with this job.
What?
For next
time. Yeah. Oh, it's right up his ass.
Success.
Now Ray, who is laughing
the hardest,
remember you want to have kids, Ray. Good.
Yeah.
Come on.
Talk about getting wet.
Well, Lee and I discussed what we should do today, and we knew that our canoe needed to be clean. It had accumulated a lot of soot and dirt from the train on the ride up. So the first thing is, just as soon as possible, we went to a canoe wash and put in our quarters. We put our quarters in the canoe wash and got scrubbed.
Yes, we did. There's all my gear in the background to show you that. What we use to clean it with.
We dried it.
So you washed both your canoe and your clothes.
And our gear. Yeah.
Oh. So that's economical.
We don't blab away on this thing.
No, that's very
we're
economical.
We clean something, we clean it all.
Then we realized there were still some spots in our shorts after the first wash, so we thought we'd do it again. And we did. And now our shorts are spotless.
And that's enough of that issue.
There's the champion fish today. Tell me, how'd you get that fish?
Well, it just it jumped in the water, so threw my lure in,
And 3 seconds later, it was biting. Pull it in.
Nice brookie.
Flopped around a little bit, but it knew who its daddy was.
Nice brookie. Well, it was a long day, but this is the campsite that we picked on a hill right before the waterfalls. Here's the falls. It's going to be an enjoyable sound all night listening to that. Wednesday morning, woke up to clothes frozen on the line. A little chilly this morning. The river's too beautiful. This is the waterfalls that we slept next to and listened to all night. I know darn well that fewer people have seen this than have been on Mount Everest. Well, after the bear got us out of camp this morning, we've hit the river at the crack of 10:30.
La Fiesta Cabrera.
Interpretation is the Fiesta of the Goat is tonight's entertainment.
I was out in the woods, and Sheldon told me to look out, man. I was thinking.
Our third campsite was at the head of a series of rapids. This was a campsite with calm waters above and a cascading falls below. It's quite a beautiful spot. Al and Tom treated the group to Eggs Benedict that morning, and it's quite a welcome treat. Before heading downstream, we organized our group picture with a background of stacked canoes. Back in the river and stretch of calm water, which we leisurely paddled through a beautiful spruce and cedar forest.
cedar bag.
Log jam. And that's not Boyne River Brewery's finest. She doesn't know quite what to do. Another shoot where we've had the portage around. In fact, we're going to set up camp at the other end of the chute to go through a rock canyon pass, right through a narrows into a pool.
Downstream, we encountered a long, narrow canyon where the river narrowed down to around 6 feet. Bob and Mike led the way by running the stretch, followed by Barry and Joe and Bud and Tom. Here's Barry and Joe with their double cadence again.
So Tom and Bud have emptied their canoe of all their gear, and they're going to give it an attempt here. After considering the shelves and rocks at the very top, particularly that shelf right there, and that stack, they decide to line to this first pool. If they don't make the first turn, they're going to lose it. So we're going to start from this position right here. He's a fake.
Hola. ¿Cómo está?
Almost. What's the menu tonight?
We're having enchiladas. Cheese enchiladas. Frijole. Spanish rice. Tequila, chips and salsa. What's dessert?
It's called gruffing.
Soap and pias.
You can go back and tell the boys how tough it was. Starved, we had to eat twigs and leaves the whole time.
They didn't care.
How's that?
How'd that happen?
Really, the floor out. Uh-oh, we got a project.
Uh-oh.
Love a project. We gotta fix the
empty cans.
Nice.
do with it? What are you doing, boy?
Give us a little song. We're making the same popcorn that my father used to make in Ireland.
What's that stick you got out there?
You're all
what stick you
got? It's shillelagh. Sure, it's the same
what's
old
the wee, what's the wee stick you got?
You're all man, you're a salt liar.
The wee stick is a whole liar.
Motherfucker.
Just a minute.
Whoa, the top's about to come off.
Well, sit down.
Yeah, good. Take that lid off and we can shake it.
Okay.
Thanks.
Oh,
you're done now.
Could be done.
It's done.
One of my board members.
Breakfast, you might have made a comeback from spilling that booze.
Worst case. And he was good. He was very convincing.
Absolutely.
You got that on camera, didn't you?
We're sending it to John.
Who's
one of your voters?
It will be edited.
Come on.
We could have him picked up at the border by the state police.
Yeah, anglers got this idea that charter school didn't work. You don't know what's going on. Charter school, God, all the kids I know that go to Concord Academy.
We're about 30 miles into the trip right now. We've camped tonight. This is Thursday morning. We're going to head downstream. Got a couple tough portages to start out the morning, and then we get into the Mattawichewan, and we'll have to go downstream 10 miles there or so and find ourselves a camp in the bush somewhere, and then tomorrow morning we'll get up and head on into the Missinaibi and into Glassy Falls.
Nice cathedral of cedars hanging over the river here this morning. We're not even a mile from our first campsite. We had to do a portage, but we couldn't run this. Unbelievable. Nobody wanted to try it.
And a short distance downstream from here was a beautiful waterfall, which we portaged around. After which Ron experimented in the eddies of the falls with the one-man paddle.
going to get it.
This is a rapid below the falls. Looks like the patch job is holding up. Sometimes canoeing is a shallow water exercise. Thank you.
after dragging them over the rocks, had some pretty tight quarters to repack in the canoes.
From the GOAT, we canoed into the Mattawichewan on Thursday with our campsite located in the middle of the river on a rock island. And then on Friday, we encountered two areas which were a combination of portage and lining. From the GOAT, we canoed into the Mattawichewan on Thursday with our campsite located in the middle of the river on a rock island. And then on Friday, we encountered two areas which were a combination of portage and lining. It was a very time-consuming and very physically difficult operation.
Well, this set of rapids was our last portage today. There was just too much to run. There's too many shelves in there. So we had to line around the side of the rocks. And as we did, we found another stream coming in. So we set up camp out here.
At the cumulus nimbus fingerus.
Oh, wait, do a spin.
Spin around so you can see the buildup of the stratus of cumulus nimbus fingerus.
Beningus clouds.
Beningus.
Tommy,
it's a hell of a storm.
The sun, we're losing the sun. You ought to get the clouds before the lights off.
This is the Gunnel Grabbers, 1999, June someday. We're in the Mattawichewan River. We've just camped at a site here with three tubes under the highway, and you see some rapids behind us. A very difficult day yesterday. We had a very nice campsite, even though it is near some highway, but we're going to go on down the Mattawichewan today, a few miles, I think maybe about 8 miles, down to the Missinaibi River. River, which we've been over many times through all the rapids. And then I think there's another maybe 8-10 miles up there to Beaver Portage, and we'll decide whether or not we're going to spend the night there or whether we go on. Hopefully not too many portages.
Was it Friday morning? Friday morning, we left our campsite, and we're just going through about 2 miles of swifts and number one rapids. Beautiful day. Lots of fun. Morning, guys.
Morning. Had a fun run this morning.
Right down the middle. Right down the middle of the stack.
Like the pirouette?
That was 180, wasn't it, Joe?
Yeah.
You guys are showing off.
Morning, guys.
Morning.
Grassed us some jet. Great when it works. Jemima. Grassed us some Jemima.
We've just left the Mattawichewan and have entered Albany Falls, which is the Missinaibi River. Large boulder fields. Beautiful day. The bottom of Beaver Falls where we camped last.
We're at the end of the Albany Rapids. There's a nice little drop here. In front of the canoe gets a little air. Gunnel Grabbers!
Wow,
downstream further and into the Missinaibi at the Albany Rapids. Another shelf in the Missinaibi River was churning white water. John and Ron got through. Mike and Al got through. Here we see John gunnel grabbing. And Barry wanted to test the temperature of the water and show the depth. Was followed by a dry out time and a warming time.
We're in the wide stretches of the Missinaibi and got a nice tailwind. So instead of paddling, we just rigged up a little sail here. Making good time. Oh yeah.
Good time.
We're in a reach now. This is the Big Beaver Falls area. This is probably the roughest water that we've seen. There's no way that you would ever canoe this, and you may never raft this. Look at that stack right there. Just mean water, and lots of it. This is Big Beaver Falls. You can see there's a lot of volume of water going through here. This is where the Mattawichewan and the Missinaibi River have formed one big river. There's a lot of water forming some pretty big falls and cutting some pretty deep crevices. Look at the power bubbling up here. This is our camp at the end of Beaver Falls. It was raining when we came in, so we got the tarp all set up. Had a nice dinner of seafood fettuccine. Very tight quarters, right? Not a very large campsite.
Visitor this morning. Came in for breakfast. Good morning. What'd you find?
It's a babot.
That's a babot.
Yep.
Found her.
Buddha.
What is it?
Groundhog.
Do you see his shadow?
He doesn't see a shadow. We're in luck.
Okay.
Peanut butter.
Oh, yeah.
Falls where we camped last night. You really can't see from here the powerful rapids up above. Beautiful morning. We're off and running, heading into Mattice. Probably about a 5-hour pull to Mattice.
Saturday morning, we camped at Beaver Falls. We just went through Beaver Rapids. We're heading for Sharp Rock. We had a short portage a couple miles down. We're going to have a golf tournament. And then we're going to head for Moose Lake. The Tice. And out.
Sharp Rock, where we found it easiest because of that falls right there, that little chute. Just too hard to go through there. About a 3-foot drop. So we lined over the rocks into a little pool. And then you gotta shoot yourself out real quick because there's a rock sitting waiting for you right there. Here they come. Go boys.
Downstream a little further, we had to line around the Beaver Rapids, and then even further, we had to do some more very tricky lining around Sharp Rock. And then a final run into beautiful glassy falls.
Last major portage of the trip. This is glassy falls. Beautiful falls.
Yeah.
It's also the site of actually the second annual Grassy Falls Open, where we'll be teeing off from the first tee right over here.
Button
it. Yeah, go ahead. Yeah, you're on.
Button it Hammer, our reigning champion in the Gunnel Grabbers Masters Tournament, Masters Golf Tournament. There's the green jacket that the champ will wear, and Bud is going to tell how we're going to do it.
Well, we're about to partake on the annual Ivanhoe Open. It's become a tradition to us, and it's really very much a part of our trips anymore. We're going to shoot for distance and accuracy. Lee will be the one and only judge for the winner.
Judge, wait a minute. I don't like that. Time out.
And he will also set up the sequence of who gets first. And
all these pressures on me.
Lee, the pressure's on. Okay, let the games begin.
Well, we should start with the champ.
There's the green. That's the flag over there, the white.
That white stick sticking up way over there. Is it called a birch tree?
Is that a line?
Birch tree.
On the first tee, the reigning champ. Alright, second up. Joe Bowers taking his practice swings. Oh, that's a championship swing.
Oh, that was just practice swing. So you know you're in the game.
You know there's worse ones than you.
Can't happen.
That could be on the other side.
This is the tradition before swinging. This year it happens to be butterscotch. Next on the tee, Sheldon Buckmaster.
Looks good. Shit!
Next down the tee is this year's rookie, Steve Kerr, playing in his first Grassy Falls Open. That's good style. Yeah, that's good style. We like that style.
Hold it there.
That was the fake.
Hey, there's two.
That's that big of a win.
Measure that one.
Ready?
Take three now.
Nope. Three tries. Good.
Holy shit. Oh, that's not even on the...
Entering the tee box is Lee Milner. He's in the Golfing Hall of Fame, but he's never won the green jacket in the Open. Next on the tee box is Al Damschroeder, who has confessed to not having swung a golf club since the last Open.
Yep.
Next on the tee is Ray McMullen, direct from the British Open, where he represented Ireland. Fine swing. Yes. It's the swing that made golf famous.
Oh, ripper!
Next on the tee box is our one and only southpaw. Yeah. Doesn't seem to know. Oh, there we go. Now he's on the right side. Actually, Tom is the originator of the open. He brought the first club and balls. And he also has the style.
Oh, he's wild now.
Representing East Jordan High School, dressed in red.
Wearing number 300 yards,
and the gallery cheers.
See, I got it lined up right here.
Yeah.
All right.
The fans are on the edge of their seats.
Oh, hey. That's a long push, dude. Oh my God!
Oh, short!
Hey.
Good. Okay, we got Steve Cole as the winner.
All right.
Of the green jacket for 99.
His name will be?
Next year will be 2000.
All right.
That's
right.
Good.
Very nice.
The check is being the mail.
Here's the check.
There's the check. You're gonna have one little swig of that, and you're set for.
There you go.
All right.
Well, after a good round of golf at the country club, it's always a good thing to just go out and take a sail.
Take a sail in the afternoon.
So the Gunnel Grabber's Yacht Club has hit the water. We're on the home stretch of the river, taking us home. Next stop, Mattice.
Final 3 hour run to Mattice with Ron and Jim leading the way, followed by Sheldon and John, Bud and Tom. Barry and Joe. Al and Mike. And Bob and Mike. Into Mattice, load up, and on our way back to Petoskey as we had another year of experience and another 100 miles of wilderness canoeing.
Well, there's the destination. That is Mattice. out. Got some of our stuff loaded. Ready to head into Hearst. Downtown Hearst and the Queen's Motel. Our final resting spot with the train station right out our back door. Down at Hearst is getting a paved highway, curbs and gutters and all. There's the Algoma Central. We packed our stuff in the baggage car. Ready to head home. All right, there's where we camped the first night. Back at Old Station. Looks like we've added a few things to our campsite.